SpaceX's sleek spacesuit changes astral fashion from the space shuttle era as a new breed of spacecraft requires a new breed of spacesuits. The first time since a decade ago, dubbed as the space shuttle era, American astronauts are expected to fly to space aboard the SpaceX Crew Dragon spacecraft, marking the first commercial crew flight for NASA, and the first time astronauts were launched from American soil in nearly a decade. When Crew 1 astronauts Bob Behnken and Doug Hurley will don their new spiffy spacesuit, longtime space enthusiasts will take notice of one thing different, that is they would not be wearing the orange pumpkin flight suits astronauts used to wear during the launch phase of shuttle flights managed by NASA. During a dress rehearsal ahead of the company's uncrewed in-flight abort test on 17th of January of 2020, NASA astronauts Bob Behnken and Doug Hurley shook hands after suiting up in SpaceX spacesuits in the astronaut crew quarters at Kennedy Space Center in Florida. The SpaceX spacesuits are a cool one-piece wide design much sleeker than the bulky space shuttle launch suits, which were also known as the Advanced Crew Escape Suits. ACES So Slim was the new SpaceX spacesuit design that in 2018, the company's founder Elon Musk had to reassure concerned Instagram followers after the reveal. "It definitely works. You can just jump in a vacuum chamber with it, and it's fine." The astronauts flying on the first crew test flight of SpaceX's Crew Dragon have also commented on differences with the SpaceX suit compared to other spacesuits astronauts have used in different years. Hurley, a veteran of space shuttle flights SDS-129 and STS-135, said during a pre-flight press conference on May 1st. Without going into much detail, he alluded into some differences to the soccer suit the Russians used for spaceflight, but he added since the circle was used as a backup if something went wrong during his brief mission to the International Space Station, but even though the SpaceX suit isn't newer, it will go through the same pre-flight checks as the pumpkin suit and the soccer suit. It's similar in that they check the suits for leaks, they check the comm system, and they just want to make sure everything is good to go before you head out the pad. Hurley said subsequently two of these SpaceX spacesuits prove their worth in space before being used by humans. One flew with the Tesla driving dummy that launched a Falcon Heavy rocket in 2018. And another was used on the dummy Ripley that flew aboard the uncrewed SpaceX Crew Dragon demo. One test flight to the ISS in 2019, if it looks like the spacesuit is built for a movie set. That could be because the suit designer is legendary Hollywood costume designer Jose Fernandez, who is known for costumes in blockbusters such as Wonder Woman, Wolverine, Batman vs. Superman, and Captain America: Civil War. Said Behnken, a veteran of space shuttle flights SCS-123 and STS-130 in a pre-flight video interview May 4th on NASA's YouTube channel, then commanded that the pumpkin suit was an iconic part of space shuttle launches, and he expects the same will happen soon for the SpaceX spacesuit on the training side, Behnken said in a separate pre-flight interview May 2nd. The SpaceX spacesuit has at least one big advantage, a high enough fidelity from a training perspective that we can both sit in a capsule. We can put on suits and we can go through a situation or a scenario where the suits are going to inflate, Behnken said. It is important for astronauts to witness that kind of experience and training to prepare for the rigors of spaceflight. Getting that level of fidelity of training hardware versus PowerPoints and virtual presentations. And in the suit is really important from an operator's perspective, so that's a huge win. The SpaceX team stepped up to that and we really appreciate it. SpaceX has kept some design features of its spacesuits private, but it has emphasized the suits are meant to be symbiotic with the large computer panels that astronauts will use to monitor Dragon systems and navigate to the International Space Station. Each suit is custom made for the astronaut according to NASA. SpaceX's spacesuit is designed to be functional, lightweight, and to offer protection from potential depressurization. NASA added the protection against depressurization would be similar to the ACES suit, which had an emergency breathing system and the ability to fully pressurize. If the cabin suddenly lost oxygen, a single connection point on the suit's thigh attaches life support systems, including air and power connections. The agency said the helmet is custom manufactured using 3D printing technology and includes integrated valve mechanisms for visor attraction and locking and microphones within the helmet structure. Don't count on SpaceX's super spacewalks, however, for the foreseeable future. Astronauts will continue to use the Shuttle Area Extravehicular Mobility Unit, EMU, which is designed to work for 8 to 10 hours or so for microgravity activities in a full vacuum. While providing protection against radiation, NASA is working on more advanced spacesuits optimized for the lunar surface for the agency's forthcoming Atmos program that aims to land astronauts on the moon by 2024. If all goes to plan, the agency will test these moon spacesuits aboard ISS in 2023. SpaceX's suits are also distinct from those the astronauts will use for the other commercial crew. Vehicle Boeing Starliner tests are ongoing to prepare their vehicle for human flight, and the astronauts' flying missions will don a blue spacesuit, which features such as touchscreen-sensitive gloves and more advanced materials, the movie star look to spacesuits. New spacesuits is just one of the innovative features the Crew Dragon astronauts enjoyed during the Demo 2 test flight to the International Space Station. Because the spacesuits were fitted to the astronauts' individual body types, Hurley added, they were much more easier to get in and out of in zero or weightlessness compared to the pumpkin suits, as the ACEs and the space spacesuits are not designed for spacewalks, just for backup during launches and landing. Hurley said during a press conference on June 1st that on board the space station, the SpaceX spacesuits were custom made for the astronauts and thus used extensively during the training for the Demo 2 mission. Behnken also gave his 2 cents on the dresses during a discussion about the SpaceX suit, pointing to some key features of the spacesuit, which was to protect the astronauts in case of fire or depressurization of the SpaceX's Crew Dragon spacecraft. Luckily enough, the astronauts didn't have to see those features in action, but it was clear that they were ready, and what better time to be doing a video on the topic than when the first all-civilian crew bound for orbit has blasted off from the U.S. state of Florida on board a SpaceX rocket ship, marking a new era in the space terrorism business. The flight, the first crewed mission headed to orbit with no professional astronauts wearing similar spacesuits to what Behnken and Hurley had to try along for the ride, is expected to last about 3 days from launch to splashdown in the Atlantic to flight marks the debut of SpaceX owner Elon Musk's new orbital tourism business, where tickets for crew reportedly cost $200 million, which would surely help SpaceX revenue soar of new heights. If the trend became commonplace amongst the thrill-seeking elite-class rival companies Virgin Galactic and Blue Origin inaugurated their own private astronaut services this summer, with their respective founding executives, billionaires Richard Branson and Jeff Bezos, each going along for the ride. This development would surely attach a new sense of commercial space rivalry, with no clear winner apart from mankind in general for every flight. That pierces through the skies, leads man to learn more about unexplored avenues, and acts as a chain reaction, where remnants of technological rivalries trickle down to more people and encourages more scientific developments, and based on close cooperation between NASA and SpaceX. It would be safe to suggest that NASA might just discard its own gear and rush to SpaceX for their new spacesuits, something Elon is very open to. That's a wrap. We'll see you later.